Hello, my name is Adrian, and in this video, we will see how to evaluate and select a vendor proposal in a bidding process. Welcome. Let's start. Remember that in a bidding process, the main objective is to find a supplier that implements a solution in order to resolve a problem or to help you to achieve a goal. In order to get the best results, you need to follow this step. Number one, you need to define the problem or the goal to achieve in a brief. Number two, you need to find a potential supplier that make a good proposal. That means sourcing for supplier. Number three, meetings with suppliers where you secure that they understand your problem or your goal and you align the timing in order to receive proposals. Number four, once you receive the proposals, you need to evaluate. You need to compare and select the best proposals. And number five, you need to formalize the commercial relationship with a push order or with a contract. In this video, we will see and focus number four in order to know how to evaluate and select the best proposal in your bidding process. Number one, define the criteria selections. There are two types of criteria, the qualitative that focus more on your perception and quantitative, the one that you can measure. In the group of qualitative criteria, you can find creativity, design, concept, way of working, style, even reputation is a point that you can measure in your vendor proposals. And the group of quantitative criteria, you can find the cost, the timing, the number of resources that the supplier is applying, the service level, the KPIs, the deliverables, warranties, etc. All the criteria that you can compare because you can count them. Number two, define the main criteria. In order to evaluate the supplier proposals, arrange the criteria by importance. You will focus on the top criteria. Usually, 3 to 5 are the key factors in order to evaluate a proposal. If you select more than 10 criteria, the complexity will increase and will take more time to measure. However, you need to find a balance between the number of the criteria versus the timing that you will require to evaluate the proposals. Here you can see two examples where we have a 5 criteria in a matrix and 15 criteria in another. Once you have defined the top criteria, you have to assign an importance or a weight. Let's imagine that you have to complete 100%. That means that you have to distribute a percentage and to assign a percentage for each criteria. You can see here two examples in a matrix with 5 criteria and in another matrix with 15 criteria. In both cases, the total are 100%. Once you have define the percentage for each criteria and you are happy with that distribution, you need to evaluate supplier by supplier each proposals. The highest score that you can have is 5 in a scale from 1 to 5, where 5 is the biggest and highest score and 1 is the lowest score. This is very important because after making the score for each proposal, you need to be sure that you will reflect the impact of the weight in your scorecard. How do I do? I usually copy the matrix in the bottom and I just multiply the score for that supplier for the weight of that criteria. And I made exactly the same for all the score for each criteria in order to impact in the criteria the weight or the importance that each criteria has. This is very important because not all the concepts or all the criteria has the same importance. If you make this, you will be sure that you are affecting each criteria with the importance that you define. Let's take an example. Here, I just assign a very low percentage for other criteria and cost I prioritize with 90%. I am making a scenario where supplier number one has very low score in all the criteria except in the cost, which I assign 5. And supplier two, I just making the opposite. All high scores, but in the cost number one. As you can see, it looks like supplier 2 has a higher score because it has 21. However, we haven't applied the weight of the importance of if criteria. That's why you need to multiply. Once you multiply, you will see that the supplier number 1 has a higher score because the cost, which is the most important criteria, are the one that the supplier number 1 has a higher rate. Number 4, compare the proposals. After making this process of scoring the proposals by criteria and assign number 5 to the biggest and number 1 to the lower, you need to make a calibration. That means that you need to see that the best options among all the proposals are the proposal that you assign number 5. In this example, the cost, which has a weight of 40%, if you assign a 5 to supplier number 1, that means that it's the best proposal in terms of cost. That means the lowest cost. And if you assign number 1 for supplier 3, that means that that proposal in terms of cost are not attractive. Could be very expensive. Let's see another example. In this case, we have a project where creativity is very important. That's why we assign a weight of 80%. In this case, you can see that supplier number 1 has a score of 5 in creativity. That means that is the best creativity among all the proposals. And as well, you can see that supplier number 3 has a score of 1 in creativity. That means that has the worst creativity for this case. You have to apply this calibration for all the criteria and be sure that each proposal from supplier are properly scored. Number 5, selection. First, you have to assign the criteria and a weight for each criteria. Then you have to score the supplier one by one. And after that, you have to make a calibration in order to be sure that makes sense your score among all the proposals. Then you have to be sure that you have to affect the score with the weight. That means you have to multiply the score of that supplier with the weight for that criteria. And you have to apply the same for all the criteria and make a total score. In this example, you can see that supplier number 1 has the higher score with 5 points. However, what happens if we change the weight of each criteria? And instead of creativity, we will reduce creativity and increase the importance of the criteria of cost. After making this, you will see that supplier number 1 is not the best proposals. And supplier 2, even we haven't changed anything, now has the higher, with supplier number 2, the higher result and score. This example will help you to understand the importance of the weight and will help you to define which are the most important criteria to you. Now let's make another change. Now cost is 50% and creativity is 35%. We haven't changed anything about the score. We're only going to change the weight for each creativity, and we're going to apply it in the second matrix where we have the number multiplied by the weight. In this example, you will see that supplier number 1 are not attractive because has 3.7. And now the best proposal is the supplier number 2 with 4.3 because the weight of each criteria has changed. In summary, this process of evaluation and select the best proposal from supplier require a matrix, and most important, requires to use mathematics, because in this point you will affect the score that you make for each proposal with the weight of each criteria. I hope this point are very clear to you, because this is the core activity in evaluation and selection. Thanks for watching the video. If you want to know more about this, you can contact through Instagram, YouTube, or Facebook. See you later.